Hello people, today we are going to start our last classical thinkers, that are Luther Gullit and Lindell Urwick. So let's get started. Luther Gullit was born in Osaka, Japan and was educated in Columbia University. He served the National Defense Council during First World War. He was associated with the City Research Institute at New York and also worked as administrator in New York. He served as a professor in several universities and consultant in administration for several countries. There are some important writings of Luther Gullit, so they are Administrative Reflection from World War II, Paper on the Science of Administration and Modern Management of the City of New York. Lindell Urwick was born in Britain, and educated at Oxford University. He was a lieutenant colonel during First World War in the British Army and was considered to be an outstanding consultant on industrial management. Here are some important writings of Lindell Urwick. So these are A Management of Tomorrow, The Making of Science or Management, and The Element of Administration. Now we will see the contribution of Gullit and Urwick. So these two writers, Gullit and Urwick, published a paper on the science of administration in 1937. After that, classical theory reached to its zenith, and these two thinkers, classical thinkers, further elaborated the idea of Henry Fayol. As Gullit and Urwick has a rich experience on the working of civil service, military and industrial organization, they focused their efforts on the discovery of neutral principle based on which the structure of organization can be designed. They said that the principle deal with the architectonics of formal organization and are directed at enhancing the degree of organizational efficiency. They have contributed to the development of classical theory of organization known as administrative management theory. And they believe that it is possible to develop a science of administration based on principles. So they did not favor organization. Which was headed by plural bodies like committees, but they consist on single top executive. They felt that a subordinate should receive order only from one supervisor. They felt that the special staff unit do not exercise any direct authority and that their job is to render technical advice and provide timely and adequate information. The objective of these staff agencies is to discharge knowing, thinking and planning functions, and they must get the things done by authority of idea. They emphasize the importance of structure in the administration. They consider structure as a designing process and devote their attention to the discovery of principles based on which the structure may be designed. They considered principle as a framework of thought and arrangement of idea to help the development of science of administration. So this is a work which they both, Gullit and Urwick, did together. Now we will see the separate work done by Gullit. So Gullit specified 10 principles of organization. So they are division of work or specialization, basis on departmental organization, coordination through hierarchy, deliberate coordination, coordination through command, decentralization, unity of command, staff and line, delegation and span of control. And in this, Gullit says that division of work is the most important principle. Gullit also identified the four bases of departmental organization, that is purpose, means function, process, means skills, persons, means clientele, and place, means area. So these he called 4P formula, where P are purpose, process, person, and place. Now he also gave the 7 elements in administration. So he says that administration consists of 7 elements, that is POSTCORB, POSD, CORB, which we have covered in the previous video in the nature of public administration. So here P means planning, O organizing, S staffing, D directing, C CO means coordination, R for reporting, and B is budgeting. So for brief understanding of post COB, you can go through the video previously in which we have covered the nature of public administration. Now we will see what are the ideas given by Urvik. So there are specified 8 principles of organization given by Urvik. So these are principle of objective. An organization should have an expressed purpose. Principle of correspondence. At all level, authority and responsibility must be conterminous and co-equal. Principle of responsibility. The superior must take absolute responsibility for the work of their subordinate. Scalar principle. A prismatical type of structure should be built in an organization. Principle of span of control. No supervisor can supervise directly the work of more than 5, at the most 6 subordinates whose work interlock. Principle of specialization, limiting one's work to a single function. Principle of coordination, harmonious functioning of different part of the organization. And last is principle of definition, means clear perception of duties, authority and responsibility of each position and its response relationship with other positions. Now, later in 1943, Urvik published his most famous book, that is The Element of Administration. In this, he enunciated another set of 29 principles, which are applicative, appropriateness, assignment of function, authority, centralization, command, control, coordination, coordinative principle, delegation, determinative, discipline, equity, forecasting, functional definition, general interest, initiative, interpretative, investigation, leadership, order, organization, planning, reward and sanction, scalar process, selection and placement, spirit, stability and staffing. So there are other books, or there are some books written by Urvik. So they are Management of Tomorrow in 1933, The Element of Administration in 1944, The Making of Scientific Management from 1945 to 1950, and The Pattern of Management in 1956. So now we will see some criticism regarding to these thinkers. So they are, it failed to understand that humans have to be motivated to contribute their effort towards the attainment of their goal. They gave importance to structure of administration while neglecting the role of human being in the organization, and they deal with the formal organization and neglect the informal organization process. So this is for today in Luther Gulick and Lindahl Urvik's video in Classical Thinker. In the next video, we will be covering classical theory, its significance and critical evaluation. So till then, do like the video, subscribe the channel for more updates. That's it for today. Thank you.